they're pointing towards, look at your people. That's the problem. I mean, they have evidence to show here when ours are not united. What's your take, Doctor?
The way I see it, Mahesh, these are problems, these divisive nature of ethnic politics or religious politics that we see in Sri Lanka and the way the outside world perceives it to be, in part, I mean, you can't rule out the complicity of politicians. Every time there is an election, it is along the ethnic cleavages, religious cleavages, whatever other cleavages, caste cleavages sometimes. That is the polarizing factor. So it's not that the people strongly assume these identities and don't think that they're Sri Lankan. It's not that. It's just that they're being manipulated.
Isn't it the curse of democracy?
It is. And you can see this happening in India. You can see this happening between Shiites and Sunnis in Pakistan. Whenever an election is coming up, you see invariably during Muharram, if an election is coming up in Pakistan, there'll be a Shia-Sunni fight. So, but we need to understand this. We need to understand how the political apparatus, devises these plans.
How can we find a solution? What do you think is the solution here?
Awareness, but you cannot have, you cannot solve problems with awareness if people don't have their basic necessities met. I truly believe that the Maslow's hierarchy of needs is in evidence in the world, anywhere you take, whatever country. Their basic needs have to be met. Then as the higher order needs are met, that's when they think about identity. So it's very easy to rile up somebody who doesn't have food to eat. It's very easy to rile up somebody who's angry at not getting a job, right? So I think development is the foundation of all of this, and then we can move on to building an identity.